tired right now. I just got back from moving all my stuff to the temporary classroom. I'm going to try to keep this pretty short, but I do want to show you how to do the math part and show you some interesting things about helping kids with values and quiz and stuff. My lovely assistant, Lua, is here. Lua, you want to come in here a little bit? Come here, Lua. So we're learning about LD50 values. That's what the whole lesson's about. But the first thing that I want to actually start off with is, I wonder if you know the difference between these three things. We got poisons, toxins, and venom. Most people use these synonymously, as in they mean the same thing. But they actually don't. These are different things. They're very specific things. Let's start over here with poison. A poison is a substance that is, it's not naturally occurring. Maybe it's man-made. A poison would be something like a cyanide pill or something that you would use to assassinate someone with. But it's not something that an organism produces naturally. A toxin is something that an organism So it's a kind of poison. You can say that it's a kind of poison, but it's a specific kind that an organism makes to defend itself. Lots of fish say that, you can't eat that fish, it's poisonous. Really, it's a toxic fish. That poison is a defense mechanism to keep predators from eating it. You only eat untoxic. That's usually why they're bright colored. Poisons are tree frogs. A little bit of a misnomer there. Toxic terms, right? Because they are colorful and they have poison because they don't want to be. And then the last one over here, venom. Venoms are kind of like toxins. They're substances that organisms produce in their own body. But instead of a defense mechanism, a venom is used as a weapon. So examples of venomous animals, there's lots of them. Snakes are a lot of spiders are venomous. You get a bee sting, that's venom that the bee is in. A stingray is venomous. There's lots of platypi are actually venomous. So anything that an organism would use as a weapon, we would say that would be a hunt or to protect their young or whatever. We would say that is a venom. Okay, so in this next little video segment, I want to show kind of visually how an LD50 value is actually determined. So LD50, let's try to kind of break that down. I'm going to write that here real quick. LD50 stands for lethal dose. Dose that would kill you. A lethal dose. 50. This 50 represents like a 50%. So half. The lethal dose of 50%. The way that they decide this, the way that they determine the LD50 value of the substance, is usually they inject it into lab mice. It's a little bit, inhumane, but this is the way that we have to do it. We have to determine if it's lethal or not, we actually have to kill something. So they get a population of mice. My population is only 4 mice. Usually they would have a much bigger test population. They ingest the same dose for a dose that's appropriate for that mouse's weight. A little bit, and they see which of the mice die. When they find the dose that will kill half of the mice, not all of them, just half of them, that's what they say the lethal dose is. They don't want a dose that's going to kill 100% of the mice, because that could end up being, enough to kill your average mouse at that point. So we say that that, we'll talk more about that in a second, how to use these numbers in a math equation like the equilibrium. Okay, so I want to show what the LD50 equation looks like and how we would read this, how we would use it. So here I've got the formula set up. On this side, we have the actual LD50 value. Right here, I just put LD50. In a real problem, this would be a number, right? LD50 is just a placeholder. It's like a variable. So this would be a number. Over here, we have the dose in grams. So that's how much of the substance are you injecting into the test subject. Usually it's these lab mice, right? And then at the bottom, we're dividing by the body weight in kilograms. So the body weight of the subject in kilograms. That's what we put on the bottom of the denominator. So let's take a look at some LD50 values. We'll compare some first, and then we'll decide how to solve an equation using this formula right here. If you don't have this written down somewhere in your notes, I would write it down right now before I on to the next segment. I'll leave it for a second so that you can jot it down. Okay, we got it. Okay, so let's take a look at some actual LD50 values so we can try to decide what is it trying to tell us and how can we compare these. So this first one that I have here, this is the LD50 value for caffeine. So it's the amount of caffeine that would be lethal to a person. What it's telling us says that it's 175 milligrams per kilogram. That's the way that we would read this, milligrams per kilogram. It's a little bit weird seeing two mass numbers in the same unit there. So let's just quickly refresh ourselves and explain. What it means is that 175 milligrams is the dose for each kilogram that the subject weighs. So for example, I weigh just about 75 kilograms. So my personal lethal dose would be about 75 times 175 milligrams. That's a lot of caffeine. You don't have to worry about going over the lethal dose for caffeine. It's not going to happen. It's something ridiculous like 80 to 100 cups of coffee for an average adult. Nobody is going to sit down in one sitting and drink 100 cups of coffee. But if you did, that would be too much caffeine. So let's compare that. The LD50 value for arsenic, elemental arsenic. That's an old school poison. We don't really use it anymore. So we can see that the number is small. For caffeine, it was 175 milligrams per kilogram. For arsenic, it's only 30 milligrams per kilogram. Now, LD50 is one of those weird units where the smaller the number gets, have rewritten the formula like I did the first time I showed you. The LD50 is equal to the mass of the dose. Usually this is in grams, sometimes it's in milligrams or micrograms even, but it'll be some sort of mass. And that's divided by the mass of the subject. This is almost always in kilograms. You really won't see it in anything other than kilograms. The top one could change, the bottom one's always if you're a triangle person, here's our triangle for this equation. The mass of the dose is on top, the LD50, and the mass of the subject on the bottom. And I know that some of us really like to rewrite our algebra equation into every variation and permutation of it. If that's you, you're in luck because I did it for you. Here we got our next one. The mass of the subject is equal to the mass of the dose divided by the LD50 value. It's the same equation. I've just moved it around with algebra because I know that makes some of us more comfortable. And then once more at the bottom here, the mass of the dose is equal to the mass of the subject times the LD50 value. So I've got lots of, trying to get all the fit on one here. I've got lots of different ways to think about this equation. It's all the same. All the same equation. I've just used algebra to rearrange it for my own. Okay, so here's the story problem that I've chosen to work on. I want to show you how we would use this formula to approach a story problem. So you have three of them for your homework. So we're going to approach this just like we have any other story problem, like we did for story geometry, like we did for the gas laws. Done these story problems a lot. I need to look and see what information have I been given. So the question says, how much wasp venom would it take to kill a 150 kilogram bear? That's definitely one of my pieces of information. 150 kilograms. And then it tells me that wasp venom has an LD50 value of 4.1 milligrams per kilogram. That's definitely also another important piece of information. I'm going to circle that. 4.1 milligrams per kilogram. So I know that my equation for LD50, it has three components to it. I've been given two components. I've been given 150 kilograms. That's going to be the mass of my subject. In this case, my subject is a bear. Now, realistically, LD50 values do not translate between or they don't translate perfectly. LD50, you know, it's a biology equation. It's a little bit of a soft science. It's not perfect. But this will help us estimate it. So it is. Anyway, this is our mass of the subject. We're going to use this for M. Over here, that's our LD50 value, 4.1 milligrams per kilogram. So we're going to use that for the LD50 value. What are we trying to solve? Well, the question says, how much wasp venom? So what I'm trying to find is the mass of the dose, M dose. What's the dose of? Well, it's the wasp. How I would do this. My formula is LD50 equals the mass of the dose divided by the mass of the subject. If I rearrange that formula, it tells me that the mass of the dose is equal to the LD50 value times the mass of the subject. So I'm gonna turn it around so I can actually write on it, and I'll show you. That mass of my subject, my bear, 150 kilograms. I'm going to multiply it by the mass of, or not the mass, I'm sorry, the LD50 value of wasp venom. I just decided that I'm going to multiply. The reason that I knew to multiply and not divide is because I used algebra to reword the equation. And I showed you all those variations a little while back. Flip back into those, or hopefully you wrote those down. So, looking at this, I can see that some of my units are canceling. I've got kilograms times milligrams per kilogram. Those kilograms are going to cancel out here. My final answer is only in milligrams. Only milligrams are left, so that's going to be my final answer. If I actually punch this into my calculator, the answer that it would give me, let me do some quick mental math here, looks like 600. Boxed up here is my final answer. How much wasp venom would it take to kill 160 kilogram bears? Well, about 650 kilograms. That's actually quite a lot of wasp venom. The bear would have to be stung by like 1,000 wasps all at once. A wasp is not going to be able to kill a bear by itself. That's what we've determined here. Wasp venom is not potent enough to take down a not unless you've got this much of it, 650 milligrams, which is ridiculous. That's way too much. So hopefully this has helped you a little bit. Hopefully you feel confident enough to take on those homework. Alright, so that's all I got for you. At this point, you're ready to tackle those calculations. I will do the calculations first, get them out of the way. Then you can spend your time working on your posters. And I want these posters to look nice. I want them to look good. So we can decorate our new room, give it some life, give it some energy. Oh, Lewis coming over. She's curious. Come here, Lewis. Yeah, say goodbye. Can you look at the camera? No, close enough, Lewis. Thank you. Spend some time working on those posters. If you have any questions about how to do the calculation, feel free to shoot me an email. Or, you know, if you're in class tomorrow, you can just talk to me. You don't have to send me an email. You don't have to pretend like I'm not here. It's okay. Make sure you get the calculations done. Make sure you make your posters. Make sure they fit my guidelines that I gave you. That's all I have for you. Enjoy your break. Be safe. Stay out of trouble. I'll see you when we get back. Remember, we're in the new room when you come back.